Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, I want to talk about dealing with siloed corporate departments. Now, I know a lot of you guys have worked at big companies as a software developer, or you've worked in a corporate environment doing software, but a lot of you guys haven't. I know a lot of you guys have only worked for small companies, or you've worked on your own. So you might not know what it's like to work in a corporate environment. And in many ways, working on your own or working in a small company is far better because you have to do a lot more yourself. You have a wider breadth of experience to see how things work. But in large corporate environments, like you'll have different departments. Like I said, in investment bank, we would have the infrastructure team, which looked after the servers. We would have the database management team, the DBAs, where they would look after the databases. We would have the networks team, where you have to get access to certain ports and everything like that. And a lot of times, as a software developer, you're coding away on a development environment, and in order to go live, you have to go and kiss the rings of the heads of different departments. You have to go and pay homage to them and say, oh, blessed network administrator, if you would be so kind, if you could find it within the goodness of your heart to open port 8080 on this server, this software developer will be forever in your debt. And it's just the way you have to go. But you have these silos, you have teams, you have to go through different stuff, and it's just the way that it is. And things move a lot slower in a corporate environment. So in working in a small company, you do it. You're working on dev, you're working on staging, you're working on production. You're just damn, bam, bam, bam. Something goes wrong, you fix it in minutes or hours. You don't have to get permission to put things live, that kind of stuff, which is good and bad because change management is what gets a lot of small developers. Like you release something before it's been properly tested and stuff like that. And in some ways, having those different departments was better, but also things move slow. But I kind of forgot what it was like to work in that kind of environment. So I wanted to tell you about this because today we had a client meeting with a company. So I'm not gonna talk a lot about the company or the application that they want, but basically they want an application to use internally for their organization. And the person making the business decisions, who's actually been in contact with us, when I ask questions, so they wanna save money. So they want to host the back-end server on their own infrastructure, which makes sense. I prefer that too, right? So we don't have to look after it, right? So when I start asking questions like, are you on Windows or Linux? What kind of software programming languages do you typically use? Because it'd be better if we use that so your developers could look after it afterwards. All that kind of stuff. Are you a .NET house? Are you Node.js? Are you Ruby on Rails? What is it? And of course, when you ask the person making the buying decisions, they're like, I don't know. I don't know the answer to any of those questions, and I didn't really expect them to know the answer. It's kind of like if when someone asks me something about my car, they'll say like, what size engine is it? And I'm like, dude, I don't know. I just, even if somebody told me, I wouldn't remember. It's not relevant to me, right? It's just, it's a car. Because the new car, which I don't really care about. So anyway, so we had to set up this meeting with the infrastructure team, and I forgot what this was like. So we get on a call, and we start just explaining the application. Okay, so it's an app. It'll be, you don't need to host it. It'll be on Google Play or on the App Store. The users will download it, but it will connect to your guys' back-end servers. So we'll need some server space, we'll need a bit of bandwidth, but it's just gonna download a bit of JSON at the beginning of the app session to check to see if there's any changes. And then there's a game, so it'll post to a leaderboard if they get a good score, but it's not like concurrent connection, so it should be pretty small. And to that I got, our infrastructure is really bloated right now. We really can't seem to squeeze anything else in on that, right? And I was like, okay, cool, no problem. What we could do is we could host it, we could get like AWS or Heroku or Azure, and we could host it externally, and then that way you don't have to worry about it. And then it was like, even the Wi-Fi on our network, if they're using it on our Wi-Fi, that would still be, it's really chock-a-block. We really have a lot of bandwidth issues. I'm like, okay, but it's really just, it's just JSON. We won't even do images. And he goes, how big is the application? Like, how much big in size? I'm like, I don't know. This is, As a software developer, if you do work for clients, a lot of times you're talking about apps that don't even exist. They're all up here. Something about, I guess, 20, 30 megabytes, depending on how many images we have in it, I suppose. And I go, yeah, so if 100 people download that at the same time, we're talking about, you know, it's like, and we start doing this kind of stuff, and it was like, it was kind of funny. So, and I was like, but don't worry, we'll host it externally. You don't need to worry about the bandwidth. It's like, yeah, but when they download the app, if they do it on site, that would take a lot of bandwidth. And so like, it was one of those things where you think, sometimes you just catch somebody on a bad day, and they just want to obstruct things. But that's just the way it is, right? You just go through that kind of stuff. So, you know, this may be the, so, and then some say, well, we'll just host it entirely offline, right? We'll have no backend server. We'll put everything in the app. We'll just keep re-releasing new versions. And in the end, we didn't really come to a conclusion, except the fact that the infrastructure, I was like, they didn't want to post anything on their infrastructure or have anything remotely involved. So this might be the first app ever where I have it. Like, you know, where you doubt when you have like big downloads, you say this can only be downloaded over Wi-Fi. So you check to see if they're on Wi-Fi. We might do the opposite. Like, you can't do it on Wi-Fi. You have to do it on your own data connection or whatever. Anyway, it's kind of funny. A lot of times you get into that situation, and a lot of organizations still run that way. They're very siloed. You got different departments. You got people who are, you know, people that are just in charge, and they might not necessarily be the people driving the business, but they're the infrastructure team, and they've got a lot more power than they should have. But you know, it's kind of funny. It's funny when you think about it. So my question to you guys, for those of you guys who have worked in corporate environments, have you ever experienced this? Because I experienced it at a lot of different places that I worked, and occasionally I still experience it now. You know, you have to go through, and a few weeks ago I was talking about how when you do work with a client and they have their own development team, you need to get their lead developer on your side. You also need to get the infrastructure team on your side too. You can't, you know, there's no getting around that. You have to go through that. We need their infrastructure. So, you know, we're gonna put together some documentation on how we can have as little effect on their infrastructure as possible on this app, which all exists up here that doesn't exist yet. It's all still in the ether, but yeah, it's the way it is. So it's kind of funny, really. So have you guys ever experienced that kind of stuff? Because, you know, it happens. Anyway, that is it for today. I'll talk to you guys again tomorrow.